In our other top story tonight, we are learning more about the death of a Lawrence North High School student. As we told you, a 15-year-old boy died yesterday at an after-school practice. Fox 59's Courtney Spinelli spoke with students today about what happened.
Counselors have been on hand here at Lawrence North High School helping students after one of their own peers unexpectedly collapsed and died yesterday while at practice. Many tell us they're so heartbroken by what happened.
It was like very heartbreaking to me when I found out about the news.
Family, friends, a school community, all grieving the unexpected death of 15-year-old Armand Rowley. His family says he loved many things, including being with his friends and watching anime.
Armand was always an awesome kid. He was always happy, always smiling, always willing to help others.
He was a very good kid, you know. He was funny, energetic.
Armand's aunt, Tasia Robinson, says they're trying to cope with this catastrophic and unimaginable loss.
How could this happen to a young teenage boy? You know what I'm saying? It's shocking.
This happened all while a track and field practice was underway, but family says Armand was there for football. While it isn't a spring sport, the district says the coach for both is the same, and Armand was conditioning at the field when he died.
I was leaving early, but it was just sad. It was traumatizing to me, yeah. He was a great kid. He was a great friend, too.
One student says he was leaving the field Monday night when everything happened.
And it just seems so unfair for him to be taken away so quickly. You know, and I feel like it could have been avoided.
Armand's family wants answers on what happened before he collapsed and whether more could have been done to help him. Meantime, they hope people will honor Armand and do good like he tried to do in his life.
And that's just the type of person that he was, always inspiring others to do better or to be better.
Be like him, like have a little bit more energy, be funny.
No officials with the district were available for an on-camera interview today, but expressed their sympathies for family, friends, classmates, and teachers here at the high school.